Holly from Summit County Historical. Good morning. Good morning. How are you? I like this little fun. This little fun, like it's like a like I don't know. Reminds me of like a Sesame Street character.
It's like spring, you know. We gotta wear spring clothes.
So this is Sally from Summit County Historical Society, and Sally, how have you been doing? How's the project been going?
Well, you know, here we are, the end of February, and so all during January and February, we've been collecting menus from the most amazing. Come on, think about it. When you come to Summit County, or when you live here, you're going to eat out. You're going to go taste those craft brews. You know, you're going to have fun out. So we've been collecting for our archives menus from Food Plus Drink, Life at the Summit 2020. So I've had some of your favorites on here. These are some of my favorites. So let's give them their little plug. Empire Burgers. La Cima Mall. You familiar with them?
Oh, yes. I've gotten many. I can't remember. I think it's the Kona Burger.
The Kona Burger? You know, I
have. Yeah, the Kona Burger was always my favorite thing.
You know, burgers and beer, they go together.
Yeah. So, I'm the red wine and burger type of person.
We'll have to work on that one. So, Empire Burgers, great place to go after skiing. And then, you know, our friend Catherine at A Basin is just fantastic.
Oh, so, absolutely. Yeah.
Have you had their Bloody Marys?
Of course.
Of course.
I'm part of the mug club there.
There you go. And they also have their Mardi Gras dinner.
So we've got the
Sixth
Alley menu right here. Okay.
And so when you look back, if you've been going to A Basin, gosh, what, 55 years? We'll have to go see what they were eating some years ago there.
I'm curious to know how much, what they were eating at Sixth Alley. I'm sure it wasn't called Sixth Alley.
That's a great question. That's called look it up. We'll have to go to that. But one of the best of this past week was a fun surprise. So I call on Kim at Dylan Dam Brewery. And she's been the general manager there. She moved out here and they started working there. And so the Dylan Dam Brewery has collected their menus.
So they started your project for you.
They did. they graciously loaned us a few. So let's look at the difference.
Okay.
So this is the current one.
This current one. This is the past one.
And so this one, and this is their earliest one from the 90s.
And I have to say, just the sheer weight of the menu.
Okay, but look. So when you're collecting things for an archive, you look for things such as, oh, they're all the same size. So they kept the same format, right? And these were courtesy Kim keeps some very nicely stored so nothing will happen to them. So we have to be real careful with them. But basically, they've kept the same format. But over time, she was telling me that they had a graphic designer who joined the staff. And so they've got, you can tell there's more
design.
Straightforward,
simple.
But they start, so she could look back at these menus and she could say, hey, we started with seven beers. And now
they've got, so you can see the... The beers are right listed there on the front page right there. I wonder if there's, I'm curious to see what anything the same. So well, their head brewmeisters are always changing too, so that naturally is going to make their beers change.
And you know, I think it'll be fun to have some of those specialists come in, a distiller from the distillery or the brewmasters. These are the folks that are bringing us that local beer that is we're so known for. So it really was a fun surprise, and thank you, Kim, for loaning us these menus and for keeping them. She's going to scan them for us so that we can compare and contrast what Summit County folks were eating in the 90s.
Well, I noticed they've got the Dam Straight Lager from their 1997 menu, and then they've got the Dam Straight Lager still on their current menu. So that must be a good beer.
I was going to say, why do you think that happened? It's a good beer. And you know, it would not be the same without recognizing now. I'm sorry, I can't even treat you this week.
She brings me an empty box of Girl Scout cookies. What? How awful is that?
Tomorrow is National Girl Scout Cookie Day. So everybody go out, get your cookies from the Girl Scouts. It's a great program.
I've noticed that some of the Girl Scouts have been conveniently located in the parking lots of the ski resorts, too.
Girl Scouts are smart. And they also will begin our Women's History Month. So next week, we'll bring you some information about Women's History Month.
Oh, sounds good.
And some women-owned businesses. Mm-hmm. But tomorrow, go support those Girl Scouts. And it's a little known fact, but once you open one sleeve, that's a serving. Just eat that sleeve of Girl Scout cookies, folks. And
let me see. So let me look at the nutrition facts here. So serving size, one sleeve. Servings per container, too.
Yes, we're not going to even calculate that. We're just going to go ski some more and ski it off.
That's a way of getting your calories. That's a way of getting your fuel for the slopes.
So. Exactly. Exactly. That's a fun part of what we're doing with this Food Plus Drink is the connection to the community and to people. The people we've been able to meet and to learn about their backgrounds and that hospitality industry that's so critical to Summit County.
It is. That's true.
Yeah.
Hospitality industry is very critical to Summit County. So, folks, be sure that you appreciate.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And go support those local folks. You can check out more. We don't have the menus up on our website yet, but you can check out more at summithistorical.org and look for those programs. And one last plug. We do have a job listed on there. We are looking for a business and program manager to help us with these kind of fun community engagement programs. So if there's someone out there in the audience that's interested, please check it out or give us a call and we can give you more information.
Excellent. I think.
Are you interested?
Possibly.
Okay.
I mean, I have in the past worked in, I was a digitization technician for Special Collections of Houston Library, and it was a great way to actually learn about the history of the place that I lived in. So
fascinating.
That is, if anybody wants to do that, check out that position.
Yeah, summithistorical.org.
Okay.
Give us a call.
Okay, well, Sally, thank you so much for coming in. Always great to learn more about the project that you've got going on for 2020. Now, folks, we're going to be taking a little bit of a break, but after the break, we are going to be doing our Watch and Win. And again, that Watch and Win is a one-day lift ticket to Arapaho Basin Ski Area, which, of course, Sally has brought in the menu for their Six Sally Bar in today. So stay tuned for your chance to win.